In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Welcome to St. Paul Serve and Prep course. Today we're going to start our first lecture about the Bible. We're going to have many talks in the Bible. We're going to talk about the classification of the books of the Bible, the integrity of the Bible, the journey of the Bible from the book of Genesis to Revelation, highlight to the four gospel. Then we're going to have selected topic from the Old Testament, like the tabernacle, sacrifices, and the Jewish feast. So let's get started. The first lecture in the Bible, the Holy Bible, part one. How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. Psalm 119, 103. The objective that we're going to cover in this lecture, to understand the difference between the author and the writer of the Bible, to learn about the early language and overview of the Bible, to introduce the four gospel, to know the classification and the structure of the Bible, to understand the connection between the Old and the New Testament, to realize the importance of the Bible and its honor, to introduce some of the fake gospel and interesting facts of the Bible. First, we'll start by knowing the difference between the author and the writer. The author is the original source of content, while the writer is a person who pens or write down. So when it comes to the Bible, the author is God. And here I have to quote what St. Peter said, "For prophecy never came by the will of man, but holy men of God spoke and they were moved by the Holy Spirit." 2 Peter 1:21. Then how many writers of the Bible? Total 40 writers. How long did it take to write it? Approximately 1600 years. The Old Testament around 1500 years and the New Testament around 100 years. The writers, who was the first writer? Moses. And who was the last writer? John the Evangelist or John the Beloved. Next, we're going to talk about the early language and the important subject of the Bible. The main subject of the Bible is God's love for mankind. For because God loved the people of the world, he created the world. Then we understand about the man's sin or the original sin. Then God's plan for redemption and salvation through prophet sacrifices event. Then execution of the salvation through Jesus Christ by his incarnation, crucifixion, and resurrection. Then preparation for eternity through preaching in the Gospel, Book of Acts, and the Epistle. And finally, we conclude about heaven in the Book of Revelation. So the whole subject of the Bible is about God's love for mankind. Because he loved us, he created the world. When we fall into sin, he planned to redeem us. And he sent us many symbols and events and sacrifices to prepare the human mind for his coming and salvation, which he did on the cross. Then preparing the believer to eternity through preaching the gospel and the book of Acts, and finally learn about the heaven. What are the original language of the Bible? Since the Old Testament was written to the Jewish, so the Old Testament is written in the Jewish language or the Hebrew language. Then Ptolemy II Philadelphus ordered the Bible to be translated into the Greek language. So he summoned 70 Jewish scribes to Alexandria around 250 years before Christ and ordered them to translate the Old Testament into the Greek language. This translation is known as the Septuagint. Simon the Elder was one of those 70, and we know his story that he wanted to change one word from the virgin to a woman, and the angel of God told him that he's gonna live until he sees this happening by his own eyes. And read about him in the Gospel of St. Luke, when he saw Jesus coming, he said, "Lord, now you let your servant depart in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation," Luke 2:29. The early translation of the Bible, first was the Aramaic, which is the mixed language between the Jewish, the Syrian, and the Phoenician, around 500 years before Christ, and the Septuagint, which is the Greek translation, around 250 before Christ, then the Latin translation, which is known as the Latin Vulgate, around 383 to 405, then English translation by John Wycliffe in 1384 AD, then the famous non-translation by King James in 1611 AD. So in total, how many books in the Bible? There are 73 books known as the first canonical books. The Old Testament contain 46 books and the New Testament contain 27 books. The Old Testament had 39 books in the copy that we have in our hand and 7 other books known as the hidden books or apocryphal books. Who collected the Old Testament together into one book? It was Ezra, the scribe and the priest after the return from the Babylonian captivity. Then what are the apocryphal or the second canonical books? Those are books of unknown authorship. They are present in the Septuagint and in the Latin Vulgate, but not in the old Hebrew Bible. There are 7 books. We print them separately, known as the completion of Daniel, Tobias, Judas, Wisdom of Solomon, Baruch, Maccabees, 1st and 2nd, and Susanna. Those known are the second canonical books. Then the word gospel. What the word gospel mean? The gospel means the good tidings or the good news. Then what is the good news? The good news about Jesus Christ, the Messiah, and his redemption to us on the cross. The paradise is open. Now the promise of the eternal life is granted to all the believers who believe in Jesus Christ and follow his life. Next, we'll talk about introduction of the 4 gospels. There's always this question, why we have 4 gospel? Why not 1? Why not 2? Why not 5? So here is the answer. The evangelists wrote the gospel to preach Christianity to different nations. So each gospel is written to certain nation existed at their time. St. Matthew wrote to the Jewish nation, St. Mark wrote to the Roman, St. Luke wrote to the Greek, and St. John wrote to all Christian. So thus, these 4 gospels cover the entire world. It's all basically about Jesus' life and his redemptive work on the cross. There are also connections between the 4 gospels and the 4 incorporeal creatures that St. John the Beloved saw in his revelation. He saw 4 different creatures. One looked like a man, and one looked like a lion. One looked like a bull, and one looked like an eagle. So the one looked like a man or have the face of a man is symbol of St. Matthew. The one looked like a lion, symbol of St. Mark. The one who looked like Luke is symbol with the bull symbol like Luke, and the one looks like eagle is symbol of St. John. And here we have a small table about the correlation between the corporeal creature and the gospel. So the first one who looked like a man or have the face of a man was symbol of St. Matthew gospel, because his gospel began with Jesus Christ's birth. So he talked about a man, and his main focus in this gospel about the Old Testament prophecies. The lion was symbol of St. Mark gospel, because Mark opened his gospel by a statement about a roaring voice in the wilderness like a lion. And St. Mark gospel focused on Jesus' miracle. The bull is symbol of St. Luke gospel, because his gospel began with the priest service and prayer, and we know the sacrifice of the priest from the Old Testament was the bull. His main focus in his gospel about Jesus' parable. The eagle was symbol of St. John gospel, because his gospel began with the in the beginning was the world, and talk about Jesus' divinity, always as an eagle flying in the sky. Next, when I talk about the classification of the Bible. It's much easier to classify the Bible into 2 books, Old Testament and the New Testament, and each one of them is classified into 5 categories. So the Old Testament is divided into 5 categories. The New Testament also is classified into 5 categories. The Old Testament categories, number 1, Law. This includes the 5 books written by Moses, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. The second category is History. This includes Samuel 1st and 2nd, Kings 1st and 2nd, and Chronicles 1st and 2nd. Third group is Poem. That includes the Proverbs, the Psalm, the Song of Solomon. 4 is the major prophet, and we have 4 prophets, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Daniel. 5 is the minor prophets, and there are 12. So it's much easier to remember that we have 4 major and 12 minor. This is the list of the major and the minor prophet. The major are Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, and Daniel, while the minor prophets are Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, and Malachi. So Obadiah, it means servant of Jehovah. He prophesied around 845 before Christ. Joel means Jehovah is God, prophesied around 830 before Christ. Jonah means dove, around 70-80 before Christ. Amos means burden bearer, prophesied around 755 before Christ. Hosea means salvation, prophesied around 750 before Christ. Micah means who is like the Lord, prophesied around 740 to 700 before Christ. Zephaniah means Jehovah hides, prophesied around 625 before Christ. Nahum means consolation, prophesied around 630 to 612 before Christ. Habakkuk mean embrace, prophesied around 612 to 606 before Christ. Haggai mean festive or festival, prophesied around 520 before Christ. Zechariah, which mean whom Jehovah remember, prophesied from 520 to 518 before Christ. And finally, Malachi, which mean my messenger, prophesied around 445 till 432 before Christ. And this was the last canonical book in the Old Testament. Some people don't like to read the Old Testament. They think it's old, let's focus on the New Testament. They are actually wrong. The Old Testament is very important. Now, I list some of the reasons why the Old Testament is important to us and why we have to read it. First of all, there are many facts we learn from the Old Testament, like God's existence. All people who deny God, the atheists, have to read the Old Testament. They know about God's existence from the Old Testament. And God revealed himself to us in many times in different occasions. They also know that God is the creator of everything. Some people still wonder who created the world, how the world came into shape. The Old Testament tells us clearly that God created the world. God is the judge of all. God's blessing goes through generation, like we have seen in the family of Father Abraham and the family of King David. God's punishment is devastating, as we have seen in the story of Sodom and Gomorrah, and we have seen with Pharaoh and his army. From the Old Testament, we learn about creation, about the original sin, its consequences, a very important topic when we come to salvation. We learn about God's plan for human salvation. We learn about God arranged many symbols for his coming. He sends person like Isaac, like Joseph, to take part of his life, or certain event like Passover or the bronze snake, or even sacrifices. All these were symbol and sign for his coming. We learn about God's law in the book of Leviticus. We know about equality between all people in terms of judgment. We know that God cares about minorities, about the poor, about the widows. We know about the freedom of the slaves in the 7 year and also in the 50 year or the Jubilee. Then when it comes to the New Testament, we're also gonna classify it into 5 major categories. Number 1, the gospel, history, Pauline epistle, apostolic epistle, and revelation. The gospel are 4. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. The history is 1, book of Acts. Pauline epistle 14, apostolic epistle 7, and the book of Revelation. So it's very easy to remember 7 and 14. So Paul wrote 14 while the other apostle wrote 7. Next, we have to understand the connection between the Old and the New Testament. What's the connection between the Old and New Testament? It's all about Jesus Christ and our salvation. The Old Testament is full of symbol, sign, event, and characters that point to Jesus Christ. Now remember, Jesus talked to the Jewish people in the Gospel of St. John saying, "You search the scripture, for in them you think you have eternal life, and these are they which testify of me." So he tell him, go and search the Old Testament, you'll find a lot of sign coming towards me. The New Testament is about Jesus' life, his teaching, our salvation, and the proclamation of the good news to the entire world. So basically, the connection between the Old Testament and the New Testament is Jesus Christ. The Old Testament is symbol, signs, event that point to him. The New Testament is about his life, his redemptive work, his crucifixion, and the disciple preaching about his life. The relation between the Old Testament and the New Testament is like relation between the seeds and the trees, or like between the foundation and the building. The Old Testament is symbol of the seeds, while the tree is full blown in the New Testament. Next, we're going to talk about the importance of the Bible and how we honor the Bible in our life. The Bible is so special to all of us. First, it's a personal message from God to you. Everyone has to read the Bible because it's a message from God. Every morning, God sends you a new message through his Bible. It is the only book that can change not only your behavior, but also your action and your feeling. A lot of time you read books that might change the way you think or the way you talk. But the Bible not only going to change the way you think and your ideas, it's also going to change your feeling, your action, and your behavior. And you can never get bored from reading it. You also can never grasp all of it, no matter how many times you read it. Every time you read the Bible, there is something new you're going to learn. Every time you read the Bible, there's a new meditation, a new idea, a new thought going to come to you. It has a special taste and attraction. It's like a magnet to the believers. Here I have to quote from the book of Psalms. I have seen the consummation of all the perfection, but your commandment is exceedingly broad. Psalm 119:96. Why should I read the Bible? At least for three reasons. To show my love for God, because he said, if you love me, you have to keep my commandment. And the commandment of God present in the Bible. So if I don't read the Bible, I wouldn't know God's commandment and don't show my love to him. I have to read the Bible to understand his commandment and act according to them. Second, to grow spiritually. As Jesus told the Satan on the mountain, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. And basically, the word of God exists in the Bible. So this is the source of our spiritual life. And to learn about God's attribute, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge because you have rejected knowledge, Hosea 4:6. To learn about God, to learn about his generosity, his kindness, his passion, but also to learn about his justice and about his fairness. So you have to know all aspects of God through reading the Bible. How do we honor the Bible? We keep it on the altar all the time. We read it on a podium. We turn all the lights on during reading. Everyone has to stand up. The highest ranked individual in the church should read it. Could be the bishop, if doesn't present there, the priest, if or the deacon. We place the Bible at the foundation of the church. And a lot of people, when they build their own homes or corporate, they actually put the Bible in the concrete of the foundation. So they want to be the Bible part of their life. The Bible became the most popular book in the world and is currently translated to all languages of the world. Finally, we're going to talk about the fake gospel and some of the interesting facts about the Bible. The fake gospel are not true gospel and not acknowledged by the Coptic Church. These are false book introduced to the life just to try to insinuate false information. Some of the example, Gospel of Barnabas, Gospel of Thomas, Gospel of Nicodemus, Nativity of Mary, Joseph the Carpenter. These are books rejected by the church. Nobody acknowledged them. They have false information about the life of Christ. Some interesting fact I would like to mention. The longest book is the book of Isaiah, 66 chapter, and the shortest book is Obadiah, 1 chapter. The longest chapter is Psalm 119, and the shortest chapter is Psalm 117. The first book in the New Testament is actually not the gospel. It is the epistle of St. Paul to the Thessalonians, the first and second epistle. I know when you open the New Testament, you always see the gospel of St. Matthew, but St. Matthew gospel was not the first book written in the New Testament. The first written book is the epistle to the Thessalonians, the first and the second. And the last book in the Bible It's not the book of Revelation. It is St. John's Gospel. This was the last book St. John wrote before his death. What else is important about the Bible? That there is no contradiction or error in the whole Bible. The whole book goes along in harmony. And actually, there are some people who try to criticize the Bible and kept on reading it and finally end up to be a believer. Some of them actually went all the way up to be a pope. We have Pope Dionysius, Pope number 14. He started his life as an atheist, a star worshiper. Then he started to criticize the Christianity and the Bible until he get to read some of the epistle of Saint Paul. Then he liked what Paul wrote. He went to the church. He read all the Pauline epistle. Then he wrote the gospel. He converted to Christianity. He joined Alexandria school. Then he became a teacher. Then he became the head of the school. And finally was nominated to be the Pope of the Coptic Church. This story just tells us about the strength of the Bible. The Bible can change people's life from evil life into spiritual life. This was the list of objectives that we cover for our today talk. Finally, I'll end with a short quiz. Who is the author of the Bible? How many writers are there? Classify the book of the Bible. How do you honor the Bible, and why should I read the Bible? I would like to end this lecture by some memorization verses. How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. Psalm 119, 103. For prophecy never came by the will of man, but holy men of God spoke as they were moved by the Holy Spirit. 2 Peter 1:21. You said the scripture, for in them you think you have eternal life, and these are they which testify of me. John 5:39. Your word I have hidden in my heart, that I may not sin against you. Psalm 119:11. Thank you much for your attendance, and I see you next week in another lecture about the Bible. And glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.